welcome to a very, very special performance tonight. You know, tonight's performance is special for a number of reasons. One, this is the final show of the 2011-12 school year for the vocal music department. I was just backstage with the performers, and tonight is a very special performance for those students that are in their senior year and will be graduating, because they recognize that this marks the end of one era and they will be boldly stepping into another era in the very near future. This is also a special evening because when you think of the Duke Ellington School of the Arts, you think of very talented young people that you see on stage performing many genres of vocal performance, but you don't necessarily think of opera when you think of Duke Ellington. But because Duke Ellington is synonymous with excellence, then we are excellent in every genre of music that the students engage in. And what you are going to witness tonight will be no exception in this street scenes production of three particular opera pieces, one being an original premiere written by one of our very own students. There are so many individuals to thank in helping to make this happen. The collaboration between the music departments and the tech departments and all of the staff members who played a key role in preparing the students for tonight. But also, we would like to thank Mrs. Betty Casey, whose kindness and financial generosity and support has allowed this production to happen in this very special way. But of all the people who are a part of making tonight happen, it is my honor and privilege to bring to the stage one very special instructor, the chair of the vocal music department. Please, let's welcome Dr. Mary Jane Kirst.
Thank you so much. We'll try not to walk off the stage here. I'd like to add my thanks to Mrs. Casey and say thank you for the sets, thank you for the costumes, thank you for all that you see, but mostly thank you for the people who we are able to involve in this because of her most wonderful support. It's just been terrific. I'm only going to come out here one time until the end, so I want to prepare you for the whole evening in one shot. The first thing you're going to see, and we're set here, I've been dying to do this, to be part of this beautiful set. This is Paris in 1920, and we have Magda, and she's a person who has a salon. Now, a salon, we might say in English, although it's also a French word, a soirée. People used, before they invented the television, people used to have evenings, and they would have their guests perform for them, and they were called a salon. And Magda is an especially wealthy woman who attracts a lovely crowd to her house. And so we have this one little taste of Puccini's La Rondine. Everything tonight is in English, by the way, because we know we don't want you to have to struggle at all. But it's originally in Italian. Even though we're in France, it's in Italian because it's Puccini that wrote the opera. The second scene is from a new work, as Mr. Pullen said, by Juan Amaya, who is a junior in the instrumental department. Now, Juan came to me some time ago and he said, I want to be an opera composer and I have an idea and I've already started. And we have spent considerable time working on what you see, and he has a plan for the rest of it. But what you see is just the first three parts of it, basically. And his idea, it's obviously a take on Cinderella, but his child is called Cinde'ella. And Cinde'ella, actually it's quite different. You could read it in your program, but you will recognize the characters, although it's actually set in the 1950s, strangely enough. So Juan will actually be in the orchestra and you will get to meet him when it comes to the bows. So I think you'll be amazed at what he's done with the story of Cinderella. When we get to Act Two, we're doing street scene. An amazing work was done in 1947 by Kurt Weill. Now, Kurt Weill, W-E-I-L-L, was a German, and he was Jewish, and he had to escape the Nazis. And so he started in 1933, he went to Paris. In 1935, he came to the United States. And he, from then forward, rejected all things German. He wouldn't even write or speak in German except when he wrote to his parents, who were still back in Germany. And he died in 1950, very young, but he did an amazing amount of work in that time. A lot of it connected to the Broadway stage, which he was fascinated by. But he calls street scene an American opera. And you will hear characteristics of opera, but you will also hear characteristics of the musical. And I think you will really enjoy this very tragic, emotional, dramatic story. So have a wonderful time tonight, and I will see you at the end.
Still lots. affliction, who developed an addiction to this very strange affliction. She'll soon become immortal through my most recent ballad.
You must show us a score!
You would find it a bore!
Your concept would be wrong!
It's love that seems a bit passé.
But love is always new. Let us hear it. Let us hear it.
I'll try it. Came my sir.